Hey folks, it's Hector Ball. It's Saturday the 30th of December 2023, a couple of days away from 2024. Merry Christmas to everyone. It's been a while. I was in hospital for a couple of days a little while ago, about 3 weeks before Christmas. And yeah, I couldn't eat or drink and I could hardly breathe. I was really struggling to breathe. And my throat was all blocked up. There was a big infection in my throat and it was expanding and choking me to death. Anyway, so I spent a couple of days in hospitals. I chopped it out and all good now. I can talk and eat and drink again and now I'm prospecting. Plus also Christmas. Christmas was busy. I hope everyone had a good Christmas. I know I did. I had lamb and chicken on the spit. That was fantastic. Along with another buffet of foods. Anyway, I'm out on detecting in the gold fields yet again. Not far from home, Maryborough. Just sussing out the area. There's an area I've been to before. I have found gold here before. And I have found gold today. So anyway, I've found a ton of ledge. I was way down the other side where the car is there, way on the other side. Very muddy, a lot of holes there, a lot of rainwater that we had last week. And a lot of these mullocks are full of water. I'm not sure if you can see that properly or not. There's a bit of water in that one right there in front of me. Anyway, so I was digging this thing and for sure I thought it was going to be a ledge shot. And even the ground itself, it's very brown dirt. It's not actually it's very loose dirt, and you know, got a bit of gold. There it is right there, little flat bit. It's a fantastic first bit since I got out of hospital and Christmas, and I might go again tomorrow. A friend of mine wants to go detecting. He doesn't get out much. He's got a shop and he's there like, yeah, you know, it's 80 hours a week, so I might go detecting tomorrow. Might bring him here if he wants to come. Anyway, that's it. See how we go and on to the next bit. Cheers. Okay folks, detectable. It's been probably half an hour since the last target. Where's my car? My car's back over there. So I'm probably about 20 or maybe 30 metres away from where I was before. Anyway, so just circling around the mullock heaps. There's quite a few here. There's millions of them here. So I'm in a good spot. And I love pipe clay. When I see pipe clay, I go nuts. I think it's got to be gold here. And guess what? Pipe clay, gold. So let's have a look at it. Yeah, something a bit sore today. There's a little bit right there. Just sitting right there in front of my finger. Nice bit. Try and pick it up. Here we go. Nice little bit. Bit of colour. Right colour, right weight. Anyway, so yeah, like when I see pipe clay, I go gaga. I love it. And I always find gold in it. So, like I said, I've found gold in this area before a few times. All small stuff, you know, nothing flash. But so far for 12 months since October last year, plus say 14 months, plus the time off I've had over the last 14 months, I found about 13 grams of gold using a 6,000, so pretty happy with that. See, here we go, want some more. Cheers. Hey folks, detectable. It's about 4:30. I'm gonna start heading back to the car. I'm a bit tired. I mean, I came in at lunchtime and my big toe is really sore at the moment because that's what I had trouble with the gout before. It's been really good for the last few months and yeah, I've been overdoing it a bit, so crouching then. I'm left-handed, so I always go down to my left knee. So anyway, on the way back, got this signal, barely surface, barely on the surface. All right, and I gave it a scrape with a pick. As you see, it's just right there, really hard as well. Anyway, so I'm sorting out the stuff in the scoop, and you see it, a bit of gold right in the middle there. So there you go, another tiny bit for the jar. See if I can pick it up. There we go, nice little bit. So like I said, it was only like not even a centimeter deep, just surface scratch with the pick. There's all the stuff. As you can see, it's just all sitting on top. A nice little bit of gold. Anyway, back to the car and see if we can get any more. Cheers. Okay folks, that's detectable. So I'm back at the detectable man cave. I didn't say that, getting mixed up. Back at the man cave here, detectable's man cave. And I'm ready to wrap up the video. So just have a look at what I found today. So there's all the lead shot I found today. That's quite a lot of lead shot. And two buttons. I forgot to put this on video earlier. Found two buttons in the one hole, along with about a dozen lead shot. I thought it was more buttons, but it's all lead shot. And yeah, when I saw buttons there. I'm not sure what type of buttons they are, whether they're shirt buttons or trouser or something else. Anyway, not bad. And the three bits of gold. So there we go. And this bit here, I think it's iron. It's magnetic, highly magnetic, but you know, I've been fooled before, so I'll chuck that in acid and see what happens. If it dissolves completely, then it's definitely iron. So that's just a bit of paint on the bench. So the three bits there, we'll chuck them on the scale and see what they how they look on the helmet on the way. The scale's over here. All right, so I'll just put them all on. Let's see where they come in. Not really much of a weight. 0.38. That's not too bad. I'm happy with that. I found gold and I'm not skunked. Anyway, so I put all the gold away. I'll probably clean up the gold. I'll take them in the ultrasonic, get all the dirt off, and all the lead in the little special jar and the buttons in the display cabinet. Going out again tomorrow with my mate Mick. He hasn't had a detect for about over a year, so we're going to go out in the same spot and see how we go. Probably won't do a video, but we'll see. Anyway, see you on the next hunt. Cheers.